Oscar winner. Is he going to throw a 7?
Here we go.
Here he goes.
He's throwing a 7.
Yes! No way!
Welcome everyone to this very unique and different video for the channel. I just visited my first Bond event, which was long overdue. It finally happened, and it wasn't a small event either. It certainly was the biggest event ever hosted by the Facebook group Shaken Not Stirred, and they really pulled all stops to make sure this one was huge. It was called the You've Had Your 60 in honor of the 60 year anniversary. And you could really tell that the co-founders Matthew Wood and Nick Fentiman truly put their heart and soul, I want to say, into this. So much dedication, so much passion, so much planning, 10 months worth of planning actually, went into this special weekend solely dedicated to Bond fans, not just like me, but over 90 people, I would say. They've invited several Bond guests, they've hosted an amazing Pinewood cinema screening of Dr. No. There was a location tour, there was a casino night, there was so much more. This was one of the best weekends of my life. Now, I've tried to document this weekend. You know, if you watch my videos, I'm not a vlogger, nor do I ever want my channel to be a vlogging channel, but this weekend was just too special to pass up on and not to document. So I tried to film bits and pieces here and there and got a little bit of footage. Obviously, this is not like the professionally edited video because I was just walking around with a phone every now and then. I wanted to live in the moment, so I didn't film everything, but I think we filmed enough to get you a little experience of what this weekend was like if you weren't there. And if you were there, it was lovely to meet you, and hopefully you will enjoy watching this back. This was So You've Had Your 60 through the eyes of me and my girlfriend Lyrit. I hope you enjoy. Hello everybody. It's 6 a.m. On October 28th, and me and Lyrit are about to embark on what is shaping up to be the best weekend of the year. We are at Schiphol Airport in Amsterdam. And we're going to go to England for the 60 year anniversary event hosted by the Shaken Not Stirred Facebook group. We cannot wait. Are you excited?
Yes.
But of course you are. The plane is already waiting for us right over here. Arrived at London Heathrow. Before we head over to Pinewood Hotel, which is outside of London, we first want to see the city for a few hours. So we're going to figure out how to get into London for a couple of hours. The last time I was in London was in 2005. I was about 14 to 15 back then when I went there. When was the last time you were in London?
A couple of years ago, 2019.
Yeah, for her it was a lot more recent, so can't
shopping.
Wait. Yeah. So I guess we're gonna go take a little peek at the Big Ben and maybe the MI6 building, we'll see. Before we head over to the hotel. So let's figure out how to get there.
Bond. What? Get on the train.
He's keen to get home.
Now, obviously, if you are in this location as a Bond fan, there's only one thing we can do. Let's recreate the George Lazenby picture. And we have brought some one in Die Another Day.
surprise, surprise, we just ran into one of my Patreon supporters. His name is Philip from Germany. Just came over from Berlin Airport.
Berlin Airport.
And Leverage is also still here. Yep. In front of the Big Bang. What a place to meet. The Big Bang? The Big Ben, sorry. And
This
is something else.
Yeah, this is fine.
I guess we're going to find a place to eat now.
Yeah.
Before we head over to the Pinewood Hotel later on to see what adventures are in store for us. So we just had dinner at the pizza place, and our good friend Philip here has called an Uber. So we're now just waiting outside here to finally make our way over to see what the hotel is going to be like. You're tired?
I walked all day long.
Yeah, lots of walking, lots of being awake.
In these heels.
But the event is still yet to start. This is just the beginning. At least we've already met one fan. So let's see what happens. Is this it?
No.
Oh no, that's just a fan.
If there's less drivers, there is more money to be made. So they're trying to always put each other off. Yeah.
I mean, at the end of the day, everybody wants to make their bread, right?
Yeah.
But you can do it. Honestly.
So, after a very long Uber drive, traffic was pretty bad on Friday late afternoon in London. We just arrived at the Pinewood Hotel. We're just settling into our hotel room here. I haven't even put my coat off, but we have arrived. Look at this room. Looks like it's perfect for the weekend. Got all the essentials here. And look at this, they even got this little stands here for my tuxedo for the big Saturday night casino event. I haven't checked out the bathroom yet, but I specially requested if I can find the light in here.
There, I have the light for you.
Over there. To have a little bathtub. Which is always good.
And we have a bidet.
And a bidet, always hygienic. A bigger bed than we have at home, so that's good. And look at the place around here. So this is brilliant. We already met some Bond fans downstairs, apart from Philip that we met in London. And we have to be at the Dr. No screening of in Pinewood Studios, the John Barry Theater, in about an hour, and I can't wait for that event. It's going to be a 4K screening as well, so I have never seen a Bond film on the big screen in 4K before, so I'm very excited to experience Dr. No in that way, the perfect movie for the 60-year anniversary. Can't wait to link up with all the other Bond fans. We've only met a few, but it's really about to begin now.
Yeah, here on Darkest.
We have arrived at Pinewood Studios and we met up with John, another Patreon supporter. Guess what? This guy came all the way from the States to be here tonight. Philip is already walking in the front. We met another Bond fan. You're on YouTube now.
Hi, guys.
And his name is Paul, right?
I'm Paul from
this
Dublin.
This is Paul. Paul from Dublin. And there it is, look at this man, the Sean Connery stage, Pinewood Studios. We're not allowed to film here too much, so we're gonna stop for here and see Dr. No in 4K and meet up with the other Bond fans. Fully seated. At the John Barry Theater. Philip and John over here. And over there is Norman Wanstall, ready for the Q&A. Amazing to see him in person. And we're pretty excited. We have to talk a little bit quietly before the whole thing starts, but Pinewood Studios.
The one that worried me right from the start was Bond on the gantry at the very, very end, where he turns the wheel. And obviously I knew exactly what I needed for that. I needed a machine that when you switched it on would sound very electronic, you know, a nuclear reactor, so it had to be a and then have a control that you could synchronize it with Sean's hands. And obviously there was a lot of work to be done throughout the film, but I tried and tried and tried to find a machine.
Good morning, everybody, from the Pinewood Hotel again. What an amazing first night Matthew and Nick have organized yesterday at the Pinewood Studios. And the incredible thing about that is not only did we get to see Dr. No in 4K on the 60-year anniversary, we also got to meet Norman Wanstall. Obviously, he won an Oscar for sound design on Goldfinger, and he worked on many of the early Bond films. It's incredible to have been able to just sit down with him and have a chat throughout the night and ask him some questions. and also Terrence Mountain was invited, that had to fight Sean Connery in Diamonds Are Forever and fight George Lazenby in Majesties. And what a character. So great to meet these two. And to be able to sit in the Pinewood Studios, Matthew and Nick have really nailed it to kick off this amazing event, because they just financed that out of their own pocket. It needs to be said, it wasn't even part of our tickets to get here. They just wanted to do it as a special thank you for supporting their Facebook group. Incredible, what great Bond fans, what an amazing night. I got to talk to Norman Wanstall. I asked him about the line with that M has in Dr. No, where he accidentally says MI7 instead of MI6. I know he does the sound design, but he also had some knowledge on the other sound designer doing the revoicing. So I was wondering if he had any clarification on that line. Sadly, he didn't, but he had some amazing other great stories. Terrence Mountain was a real character. He kind of started hitting on Lyric throughout the night, which I found very amusing. And if anyone is allowed to do that kind of stuff, it's people that worked on a Bond movie. So especially a guy like that, just, you know, poking some fun. He was very respectful, don't get me wrong. What a nice character to be able to meet these two. One of the other people that I got to finally meet down there was AJ Chowdhury, who you may know as the author of Some Kind of Hero. I actually walked up to him saying, "You must be some kind of hero." And he was like, "Hey, Jeroen!" And we immediately hit it off. And he's like, "You're the final Dutch, member of the Bond community that I was yet to meet." So everything went full circle, he kind of mentioned. And such a humble guy, so such a sweet man, I would say. And very great to be able to have a chat with him as well. Unfortunately, he won't be here for the whole weekend. He was just there for the Friday, because AJ is a busy man, very understandable, but I'm sure we'll meet him more in the future. But great to be able to meet other guys like that as well. And then after Seeing the screening of Dr. No in 4K as well. What an experience to experience it in a theater that is property of Eon, basically, where probably Barbara and Michael are occasionally sitting to see early screenings of whatever movie comes out. And just to be able to sit there in a room full of Bond fans, all very familiar with the movie, but to experience it in a theater, especially in a place like that, oh, it's something else. Yeah, and then after that, there were drinks and more drinks. So it became quite late. We were the last table to leave. But now it's time for breakfast because Matthew and Nick have organized so much more on this Saturday. There's plenty of panels of other Bond guests arriving today in the conference room downstairs. And we are going to go for the big event where I've got my tuxedo ready for at the casino tonight, as well as do a fun Bond quiz throughout the night, which I also cannot wait for. I've already made tons of new friends here, and it's been a really great first night, so let's just see what the second day brings us.
So the camera could see what I was doing, and I shot him. And he stood there with egg on his face. I said, "You're dead, you cunt, get down, get down, get down." So he's still looking at me. So I got carried away and been a method actor. I hit him twice with a gun on his head, and his head just burst open.
Where are you? Who will you? Take my unfinished life and make it complete, just like the rules. Everyone, come on, to me. Will come true someday. I know you are only a kiss away. I see your smile. A thousand dreams, oh, there's your touch, and it always seems to love me.
And you know, without saying anything, Vernon as well is in his 90s, so you're officially our oldest ever guest.
94.
That's incredible. Thank you for being here tonight. I appreciate that. Thank you very much.
I've had 30 years.
So what we do is I'll ask a question to each of you along, and we'll try and get some interesting information. And if we don't, we'll just make it up.
You know, the scene was Pierce was going to open a submarine door with my head. And the stunt guys were over on another stage, and they go, "Oh, when are we going to do this scene?" I said, "Come on, let's just do it now." They said, "But you can't do it without the stunt guys present, the insurance, you know." Anyway, time went on, half an hour went, and Pierce and I are practicing it, and we thought, "Fuck it, let's just try it." So we've done it, we've gone for it, bang, 13 stitches in my head.
I do want to say that I never got any of those locations. I'm hearing Caroline talking about Sardinia, and then you're talking about being up a mountain for 4 months, sunbathing. Yeah. Well, I was in an icy, wasn't even a studio, just a great aircraft hangar, really, and stuck in the corner, last scene just about of the film to be done in Live and Let Die. Frozen, we both were. Roger and I had icy feet. Icy everything. So no locations for Maddie.
No,
everybody else did. Jane did, didn't she?
Yeah.
Where did they go, Matthew, actually?
I thought they went everywhere. Just not in the wardrobe.
No, New Orleans.
New Orleans, Louisiana, that kind of thing.
Jamaica
went everywhere.
I would have liked Jamaica. Can I go back and do it all over again?
Okay, over to Jerome. Final question for today.
Question for Caroline, if you can hear me.
Hopefully,
yeah. You also worked with Barbara Bach besides Roger Moore.
I did.
Obviously, your characters didn't get along on screen, but I was wondering how it was off screen, if you got along with her and what your relationship was like with her.
She was a lovely lady. She was very, very sweet lady. And we did get on really, really well. But hopefully that came across that we didn't, you know, there was a slight tension between us. So that was good. No, she was great. And I saw her actually a few years ago. We were at the garden part, what's that one? You know, the big garden thing that they have in the centre of London. Yeah. Yes, I saw her there. She was there and she came over to me actually. I hadn't seen her at first, and then she came over and she looks just the same. She looked just gorgeous and came over. We had a chat, chatted about her kids, talked about me and my children and stuff. And then she said, I'd like you to meet my husband. And then he came along, and of course it was Ringo. And so we had a nice little chat, and that was lovely to meet him. And then suddenly the people started to come, and Ringo said, come on, Bob, let's go. So they went, they left. But no, she's just the same, and I got on really well with her. And I think she played Anya really, really well. I think she was super for that. Perfect.
I agree. Thank you. So, what did I just get? Signed picture of Caroline Monroe, Naomi in The Spy Who Loved Me. What a lovely woman, wasn't she? You liked her as well?
Yes.
She was really, really nice. And Terence Mountain, of course, gave you an unpaint, because he keeps hitting on lyrics the whole weekend. What a character. Unpaint autograph. And Lyric didn't even ask for it. He was just like, hey, you want to have an autograph?
Of course.
Terrific, man. Really great. You know, I want to get a bit more, but we will see if we can get a bit more. They're obviously not
with the
for
Bond
free,
girls.
So we will see. Also, this is the brochure of the whole event. Turns out I'm actually quoted inside this thing.
Yes.
Over here, there's a little piece they put of me. I never realized. He also asked David Suritsky. Of course, you can't miss out on him. I wish he was here. But yeah, pretty cool to be inside this this whole thing. What do you think of the weekend so far?
It's a lot.
Is it a lot?
It's a lot, yes.
Why is it a lot?
A lot of people, a lot of bonds.
Yeah.
Yes.
Are you enjoying yourself?
I'm enjoying myself, and you're happy, so I'm happy.
That's good. And are you looking forward to
the casino night?
Yeah.
Yes, I have my dress.
Yeah, this is the piece you've been waiting for the most, probably.
But now I don't know. I'm too nervous.
I wish I taught you how to play poker beforehand. I should have taken the time. I am gonna teach you though, but probably tonight, you know, you can do the Daniel Craig thing where Vesper comes walking and you can stand behind each other so that you can, you know, distract my opponents, kind of walking behind them, and that,
well,
you know, Vesper does that for bar.
I have a red dress, so maybe.
Maybe it works. Have you filmed
no.
the hotel? You can do a little outside tour. Standing. Look at the place. All of these people here are Bond fans that we're staying at with. And it's like, you know how this feels, being here? It feels like we're in a school camp. You know, back in the old days when you were in school and you were having fun with all your friends. It's kind of the same premise, only now it's a school camp filled with Bond fans. Looking good, my man. John over here. Welcome.
Yep.
Our Oscar winner, is he going to throw a 7?
Here we go.
Here he goes.
He's rolled a 7!
Yes! Yes! No way!
The good news is, when the puck is off, 7.
I knew he was going to. And look where I placed my chip. On the 7. Playing with an Oscar winner. Goed zo, schat.
Okay, 87, 4-1, 8.
When do you get to play poker with Norman Wanstall, Terence Mountain, and all your friends in a James Bond casino? And all of this goes to a wonderful charity as well, all the money we bring up. So this is truly amazing.
How's your night?
It's amazing. This is once in a lifetime, isn't it? Just bought a drink for Norman Wanstall, Oscar winner for Goldfinger. When in your life are you going to play with an Oscar winner and loads of your friends, you know, online from Germany, from
from America, from France, and play on the craps table. It's incredible. How's your night, babe?
You feeling the alcohol?
I lost a lot.
But you also won some.
Yeah.
You were on a lucky streak.
But I was like dicing. I don't know how to call it. The dices. I had to throw the dices.
Yeah.
But nobody won.
Oh.
Everybody lost when I throw the dices. So.
If you want a tip, if you're ever playing craps, play with Norman Wanstone. He's not only an Oscar winner, he's a craps winner as well. Every time he guessed right, his stack of chips was like this. So there's a lot of money going to the good cause. Thanks to our Oscar winner for gold. We're gonna try the roulette as well, right? Let's go ahead and...
Yes, but look at this.
That's a shame. Odd number on black. Let's see what happens. Lewitt has been quite lucky tonight.
No.
Well, you have been playing a seven and it was a seven.
Well.
See what happens. I want an odd black number. It's on 35. That's good. 35 black. Now it's somewhere else. 20 even, but it's still black.
Oh, yes.
I won a chip. Are you doing, Philip?
Yeah, I think I'm doing good, right?
Yeah, you are. I mean, your stack looks pretty decent at the moment. Yeah, and he's playing with a great collar.
Your 007 shaken but not stirred 2022 winners. We're going to go in reverse order. These are the people that cashed in, so really you're not last because people end up with $0. But in 20th place, Steve B with $90.
£90. Good job.
19th place was Philip on 100. 18th, Ian.
Well done, Philip. Well done. You did it, man. I mean, it goes to charity. That's great.
Lyrith on 210. Made a tiny £10
profit. Well done.
15th, David M. 220. 14th, Craig H. The jukebox.
I mean, 210 is not
bad. I think £60 that was his knowledge of Bond songs. We carry on. 13th, Adam, £300. Another Adam, 310.
Oh, that's
which Adam?
Philip Hawkins, 350. Anita, 350 as well, joint. Norman, the craps man.
Yeah, the craps man.
All night on craps.
Give it up.
Doing it. Doing a
crowd.
It was Mickey, 370. Seventh was Amalan, 380. Stenmark, £400 in sixth. Paul, fifth, £400. In fourth place, Bethan, 420. We're now into our top three. Third place, Franz Middle.
Wow, look at this.
It's Chris, 520. Round of applause for Chris.
Oh, Chris, where's Chris?
Right, our next person is actually a prize winner. This person started with $200 and turned it into 1,000. It's so, unfortunately, we had some chocolate that went missing, so I don't know. So, we have got a tote bag, and you've got a cardboard box. I'm joking, there's a mug in there. Fantastic. Well, Lena!
Yes.
But we have one more winner to crown. This person, obviously got more than 1,000, was our top male tonight. This person should get the next flight out to Las Vegas. It was David!
Yeah.
Photos, smile for the camera.
Well
Well done, guys. Well done.
Champagne glasses are ready. Bollinger, very nice.
Now we do. Goes to the good cause.
We do have one more surprise present for our top child. Is that right, Matthew? There's a top child. So
and he's still awake as well.
Elijah, come out. You've got a prize. Wow. So what have you got? You've got a DB5.
Oh, the DB5. That's incredible. Well done. Yeah. High five, man.
11 PM, still going strong.
Yeah, you got it. Oh, look at this little bond. You got it. Incredible job. Well done.
We're on to the lottery now. These are our numbers. Fingers crossed indeed. Matthew is over there. Someone standing in front.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
Oh, am I to the fullest? There is not a place on earth I'd rather be right now. Honestly.
When you get the film, that's worth the point. So. There we go, someone's good at that. Okay, let's move on. First question. When it comes up, are you looking for shells? No, I'm just looking. Start the clock. This one shouldn't take long.
So it's a product you can actually buy in the market.
Question two. Here we go. The timer has started. Anything can happen. Okay, two cards, Bond's hand, Jack and
eight. Okay. Oh, okay, so we got a half
point. We have an ace and eight.
They only give us a half point.
If you bought one of the cards, you get a point. There's only a few.
Here we go, guys.
So,
hopefully.
007th place, which is a liar because we expected there to be five tables. Seven tables. Let's get that one. But there you go. But if you were 007, you are Nigel Small Forces. You know no fear, you know no danger, well, you know yeah. Nothing. But we don't need to know. Well, it's pretty good. Okay, 006th place, which we don't need to concern ourselves. Your Asian cards are slightly deaf under pressure. You may have missed a question. 005th place, you're very good knight. You've tried your best and bumbled your way through this quiz. And that is 007GB with 15 points. Give him a cut, guys. Well done. 15 points there.
We fumbled your way.
Okay. In 004th place, you are Jaws. You've been strong, resilient, and a bit of chunk out of this quiz.
That's
right. So that's 008 with 18 points. Well done. Is that right?
We're still in it. We can still win this. Come on.
In 003rd place, your Q, intelligent and forward thinking. However, your gadgets didn't help you this time. And that is Dan Coffey with 21 points. You know what? You are only six points.
Oh my god.
Okay, this is very, very close now. This is very tense. In 002nd place, your Blofeld, your quest for world domination has sadly come to an end. And that is, to be fair, the writing's on the wall for this one. No. Writing's on the wall, 25 points.
We're first.
RM, you persevered, remain strong, and are the head of intelligence. Okay. They're piss fillers. Is that that table?
Yay!
Congratulations. And we do have a prize as well.
Well done. We did it. We won. We won the quiz night.
Yeah.
Well, we did. So?
I mean, we're missing some of our teammates.
Yeah, we're missing a lot. So give a speech.
I would like to thank my mother and my daughter.
Congratulations.
We're missing some of our teammates.
Yeah.
Well, they didn't help, did they?
No, yeah. Actually,
for the fella.
That's why you won. What's going on?
The fella with the number 26.
Number, oh, it's you.
Oh,
you won
also. So
awesome.
Basically, what's going to happen?
Yeah.
We've got loads of postcodes in the number they sent you from. So you're going to take the postcode, postcard each. And also, you have a print.
Oh, yeah.
Which is, Stu, are you in the room still?
Holy shit.
Stu, absolutely talented graphic designers. Draw these sketches from hand. They're absolutely incredible, so yeah.
Amazing.
These are from Stu, so we'll give 1 inch and then you can. I'll put these on here.
Yeah.
You can choose one, select one. There's pretty much every film here, I think.
Okay.
So there is loads, eh?
I'll grab License to Kill if you don't mind.
Yeah.
License to Kill is there.
Babe? Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you today after?
Still stumped about everything that happened last night. When do you get to play? I said it yesterday, right? With like hanging out with Terrence Mountain, Norman Wanstall, all your Bond friends playing craps, playing roulette.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone dressed up. All staying over at the same place, and it's not even over yet. There's another adventure awaiting today. It's incredible. How was your night?
I'm just fine. I played the roulette.
You were really lucky too. You did quite well.
Yes, I was very lucky. So we have to go to a real casino.
Right.
Back in the Netherlands.
Oh, we must.
Now we need to eat my English breakfast.
Yeah.
What did you think of the night yesterday?
I won a lot.
You did, you won, yeah. A lot of money raised for the charity too.
Yes.
That was great. And also, because, did you understand anything about the roulette and especially the craps?
Well, the roulettes I did in the Netherlands, so I knew the
right. That's,
I knew the rules. But that other game with the dice?
Yeah, craps.
I didn't know.
You just started following everybody, you started following Norman.
Norman, because he won every round, so I said that to the guy next to me, to Philip, I said, well, we have to follow Norman.
Yeah.
We have to do everything what he does with his chips, and then we win.
Yeah, and it's true, and he was a really one lucky guy. I mean, that's why he's an Oscar winner, I guess. No, he's not just lucky, he was really talented, of course, too, but I mean, he was so much fun to be around, and it's so surreal. It's funny, he confused me to be Chris Wright of James Bond Radio. He was like, you came to my house. I was like, no, this is the first time I met you. No, but you're James Bond Radio, right? I know you. And he was confusing me for Chris, who was a great guy. I wish he could be here. But yeah, that was quite a funny experience. Obviously, I explained to him and I showed Chris's picture. Like, no, you're confusing me for him. And he's like, oh yeah, that's right. So he did understand. But yeah, that was a fun experience. But yeah, it's gonna be a while to take this all in. I don't really have the time to take it in either, because as soon as I'm arrived,
well,
I arrive
I
back.
See.
We have to work, yeah. Both of us.
I see everyone in the parking lot now. We have a view on the parking lot.
Yeah, we're gonna go for Bond locations next, and looks like most Bond fans are already down. So we're gonna go downstairs as well and see the first location, which I think should be the church, the graveyard where supposedly Tracy Bond in For Your Eyes Only was buried. It's a real graveyard, so obviously we need to be respectful there, but let's see what happens there.
Well, this is where I parked before. I used to be able to drive in.
Oh, right. So we're now at the graveyard.
From For Your Eyes Only.
Yes,
the scene where Roger Moore stood in front of Tracy Bond's grave, putting down the flowers, and then the helicopter comes down somewhere here. I need to figure out the geography, but this was definitely seen in the movie.
I took photos of my telly and they're all on my phone.
Yeah. Oh, they're showing. I think Nick is showing the scene now. Filming it.
There we go.
Oh, I'm just seeing the reflection.
Yeah,
yep. Yeah, there we are. Same spot.
Yeah, it's about in between here. Yeah, I think this is where I sort of researched it, about here.
I see two small little turrets.
Yeah, but that changes, doesn't it? Yeah. So basically, that's the scene, and then the helicopter lands in that field there. And
that's where the helicopter lands.
Where are we?
This is Shrubland, which was featured in Thunderbolt.
Okay.
It still looks very similar to how it looked in 1965 when they filmed here.
Cubby's car, and there's actually in the film.
Oh, yeah.
Parked here. Ken Adams' car. Can't remember who the other two are, but I know that them.
The Vowles car,
though. Yeah, I think it probably was. But I remember them two because they weren't really supposed to. They just literally rocked up because they're there for the filming. And it's just. Yeah, and when you watch the film, it's in there.
That's good.
Yeah. Well, I spotted Cub 1 as well. Ooh. Oh, yeah. So then I got the picture up. Sorry?
You're not able to
take
the
I don't think he's got the clip on there. But I don't think it's available on YouTube either. I don't think it's, because it's a sort of certain part of the film. I don't think it's as iconic to be usually YouTube. I'm driving the jetpack.
There's no NATO base next to it though, like in the movie.
So the next stop is Black Park?
Yes, that's right.
Which movie is filmed there?
Oh, multiple movies are filmed there, but you need a lot of imagination to spot them.
Oh. So, we are going to be looking at interesting things, right?
No, trust me, it's going to be great.
So this fence is where they're turning in?
Now they're in the Pinewood. Yeah. I believe
I had no idea.
Is actually within the studio.
Yes, it will be. Yeah.
Grounds that bit.
So where they're turning.
The tarmac path.
So these last trees would have been these things here.
Yeah. So if I just go back.
So you'll need to go and pause when they turn around the corner.
So here,
which is this bit here.
Here we go.
Yeah.
That's it.
I know,
it's crazy.
It doesn't even look like we're in the same.
Yeah.
But
that's what
I've tried to work out. That is.
So after a long drive, we made our way over to Madagascar. Yeah. And this supposedly is where they filmed Casino Royale, the parts, and we still have to walk up there now. Casino Royale was filmed here, right?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, we'll take a look when we get there. Matthew will explain it all, and then it will make more sense, because right now we're walking up to a lake. It doesn't look like Casino Royale yet. And also, Jurassic Park supposedly was filmed here. This is Black Park. So we're taking a look.
Jurassic World. I actually was here when Jurassic World was filming.
Jurassic World.
Yeah,
the new one.
Yeah, the new one. I can tell you whereabouts. Yeah. I can tell you whereabouts because I remember it being shut off, and they had fake moss on the trees. Yeah.
This one here.
Yeah. That one there.
So this is supposedly from Supergirl, a little bit of trivia from Matthew here.
Right, okay, so that's just another location. Right, okay, should we go to
the piece of dirt from Bond? We've made it. The correct piece of dirt.
In July 2006. Between the Tuesday and the 2006 when they film it, because every time they film here they have to put a notice up to make people aware. So right. Notice reads, please note that the new James Bond movie, Casino Royale, will be filming scenes in the middle of Black Park on Tuesday the 4th and Wednesday 5th of July from 7 a.m. till 8 o'clock at night. During our filming at Black Park, there may be the possibility of some gunfire for the scene, although it is not currently planned. We will have animals, dogs, goats and chickens on our filming set as part of the scene.
Also in Black Park, this somewhere here is where Art Job threw his hat to Tanya Mollett, who played Masterson, Tilly Masterson, with the head. I think Matthew can point it out.
Official camera person.
Tilly Masterson, the Goldfinger, Ashton Scott. It's on job.
Here.
Yeah, so we moved from Uganda to Switzerland right now.
Yeah, here we go. It's amazing what you can do in 30 seconds, right?
Yeah.
So they're thinking.
at the place of 009, I think.
Yeah.
The chase of 009 with the twins was here. So you're looking now at guys who are like discussing if it was here or not. At this tree. Or anything?
The balloon.
Oh yeah.
Give us a clue.
We're looking at trees now. We've gone to that level.
So we already looked at the fence. We already looked at the ditch, and now we're looking at
outside of
trees.
And now we're looking at trees. This is the level of dedication we Bond fans have, and no one's complaining. Everyone's having fun.
Looking at trees. It was a nice hike in the woods.
Yeah.
Yes? With your jacket?
Yes, yes.
So we're in Germany now.
Yeah. Yeah, so we've been to Uganda. Switzerland.
Today we've been to Uganda, to Switzerland, back to Germany. And you know, now we're slowly going back to
in one forest.
And Kentucky.
And Kentucky,
oh, yeah.
Yes.
Kentucky as well, yeah, we visited that as well.
Oh, look, a squirrel. Oh, it's gone.
Wow. Right, where is it?
So.
Yeah, so we're trying to figure out the correct.
And look at the shoes.
This is the dedication, and these were new.
So, John brought a board game for evening number three, and it's called Spectre. Yeah, now I'm very curious about this one. We just said our goodbyes to Matthew and the host. And we're the last one standing in the Pinewood Hotel, pretty much the last evening, and we're gonna play Spectre. Can I be Blofeld, or how does this work?
Oh, we skimmed through the rules a while back.
We need to figure it out.
Maybe something like this.
Who are you?
I think it's on. I'm Ernest Stavro Blofeld.
Sorry, can you say that again?
I am Ernest Stavro Blofeld.
Oh, this is your cat?
You've only lived twice, Mr.
This is your invisible cat.
Hopefully, this video gave you a little taste of what this event was like through our eyes and quite how special it was, certainly to me, but I think to most other people, if not all other people that attended this event, because this was just incredible. Thank you once again to Matthew Wood and Nick Fentiman for putting all of this together. I can only highly recommend going to their events. I think that you've seen in this video quite how special it was, and who knows, maybe in any future Bond event we will get the chance to meet as well, because they are truly worth it, especially hosted by this lovely group. Hope you had a great time watching this video. See you guys in the next one.